In the previous video, we talked about entities and we talked about attributes. Now, we know that in ERD, we have three main parts: entities, attributes, and relationships. So in this video, we will start talking about relationship. So the idea of relationship, we can think of it as the glue that is going to hold the ER diagram components together, because we cannot have any entity that is floating in the ER diagram. If it's floating without any relationship to other entity types, then that entity type does not make sense to the organization, or is not relevant to the organization that we are trying to model, so we exclude that entity. The basic idea is that an entity plus another entity is equal to a relationship. Now, it does not have to be two entities, it can be more than two entities, and we can also have a relationship from the entity type to itself, as we will see in upcoming examples. Now, this figure shows us the relationship between the employee entity type to the course entity type, and the relationship is completes. So this says employees complete courses. How do I know how many courses are completed by how many employees? Will each employee complete one course or multiple courses? Will each course be completed by only one employee or multiple employees? We will be able to determine this by the cardinalities right here, and this is something we will talk about after this. Now, as we have entity types and entity instances, we also have relationship types and relationship instances. So the relationship type is a meaningful association between or among entity types, while the relationship instance is an association between or among entity instances, where each relationship instance associates exactly one entity instance from each participating entity type. What do I mean by this? Let's look at an example that is going to clarify things. So if I look at this figure, on the top I see here that I have employee entity type and I have course entity type, and then I have the relationship type, which is completes. That is an association between those two entity types. If I look at the bottom here, I have employee instances and I have course instances, and then I have relationship between the employee instances to the course instances. So on the top part, it shows the relationship type, and in the bottom part, this shows the relationship instance. Now, why do I have some of them as dashed lines, some of them as dotted lines? This is just for making it easy to read. Now, why do I have some of them are blue lines, the other ones are black lines? Again, it's just to make it easy to read. Do I have to have the entity type in blue? The answer is no. It is just to make it easier to read again. Now, let's look at this exercise or example, which is going to help us in being able to establish relationships. So the entities I have in here are landlord, building, and tenant. So I want to build relationships between those three entities. So from landlord to landlord, which is the first cell right here, do I have some kind of a relationship type? The answer is no, I don't have any relationship type. From landlord to building, do I have a relationship type? The answer is yes, the landlord owns the building. And then from landlord to tenant, do I have something? Yeah, the landlord collects rent from the tenant. Now from building to landlord, do I have any relationship? Again, yes, the building is owned by the landlord. Remember where here we said owns, because the landlord is the one who owns the building. But now I'm going from building to landlord. So the building is owned by the landlord. From building to building, nothing. From building to tenant, the building is occupied by the tenant. Then from tenant to landlord, we also have a relationship because the tenant will pay the rent to the landlord. Now from tenant to building, we said from building to tenant, it's the building is occupied by the tenant, so the tenant occupies the building. And finally, from tenant to tenant, we have some relationship. The answer in this case is no. So we can fill the table in this way. And this will show us the relationship between those entity types.